button of Fresenius 4008S is located on the upper left corner. The red conductivity port must be placed in the acid mixture. On the other hand, the blue conductivity port must be placed in the bicarb mixture. Once they are in place, press the test button for the T1 testing, which will be analyzed and tested by the machine itself. Always perform the required T1 test before the treatment session starts. Never use a machine that has failed in T1 test. Once the machine passed the T1 test, place the venous chamber on the air detector and secure it in place. Get the dialyzer and check for the full name of the patient, the date it was last processed, and the number of use. Remove all caps or covers and make sure you have prepared a bucket right next to the machine. Dialyzer port and connect it on top of the dialyzer. Do the same and connect the venous dialyzer port at the bottom of the dialyzer. Make sure that you have secured them both well. Dialyzer on the holder. Open the shunt cover and attach the couplings. The red coupling must be placed on top and the blue coupling at the bottom. Secure them well and close the shunt cover. Press the menu button, which is right below the US button. For the Ecopriming, set 500 ml for 10 minutes if dialyzer is being reused, whereas 300 ml for 6 minutes if brand new. Unclamp both lines, press confirm, turn on the UF and flow, press start button, and increase the BFR to 250. Dialyzer, which means blue must be up in order to expel air bubbles. Make sure there are no kinks when you are inverting the dialyzer. Be observant and make sure to press start whenever the blood pump stops. continuously press start button when it keeps stopping. Expel the air bubbles from the venous chamber by loosening the cups. Gently tap the dialyzer to expel air bubbles. If you look closely, you can see the air bubbles on the dialyzer. Once there are no air bubbles seen, revert the dialyzer, which means red must be up. Make sure there are no kinks on the couplings and the lines. Once Ecopriming is done, the screen will say UF Gold Rich. Then, go to System Parameters. Press the plus button to select Yes. Press Confirm to delete the data in Ecopriming. You will see that everything went back to zero. So press Menu and make sure to ask the nurse what you will set for the patient's UF goal. Before starting the HD treatment, conduct a residual test to make sure that it is safe for the patient. This is done by removing a few drops of NSS first, then one drop for the test strip. When it is white, it means it is safe to use by the patient. After the patient's 4 hours treatment, post-HD assessment is taken and recorded. This includes taking the patient's vital signs, weight, and assessing the patient's condition for any post-HD complications before going home. Thanks for watching!